Hello, my name is the Intuitive Healer, and today I would like to do a reading for the sign of Scorpio. So I've already pre-shuffled, and I wanted to let you guys know before I put the cards out that sometimes unexpected things can show up. And so if they happen to show up, we work through them, we allow them to be transmuted, and we let that energy go, we heal it, and we move on to the next new beginning. So first card that comes up is the Prudence card, the Eight of Pentacles. And so with this card, it's saying that in the past that there were some things that actually just really didn't come to the surface, that possibly there was a situation where nobody really was voicing their truth here. And with that being said, is because there was a lesson to be learned. There was something that needed to be understood from the past. And so we've worked through a lot of that karma, but we are striving towards a new direction. And Scorpio, I want you to know that we've got the Queen of Cups energy here. And so that signifies a lot of good. This is very powerful energy. This spells prosperity, abundance on all kinds of different levels. And so with that being said, I like to say that once we head into the Queen of Wands, we do allow ourselves to see a different light, maybe in igniting the flame within us and really seeing our true worth, our true value here. And with that being said, I believe that it's been a lot of time thinking about this very thing. Am I valuable? You know, there's been some real isolation here from the past, maybe really understanding who you are and what you need in your life in order to move forward. Now, we know that the Scorpios are very intense, and so the Queen of Wands is just kind of creating that intensity again, really bringing yourself back to the past energy of that really powerful, I say strong, insatiable energy. So we do have this virtue card, and I believe that it's in relation to the Eight of Pentacles, because it did say there were a lot of things from the past that maybe spelled changing your mind or maybe changing your viewpoint about how you felt in order to stay in a situation. And so with that being said, it's saying that there's a new chance here to move into a different way of thinking, maybe to allow yourself to really support your value system here and maybe not get yourself in any situation that maybe is not to your honor, to your virtues, to your beliefs. And so you have an opportunity here to change that with the virtue card. Now, in the past, we did have failure with that. We didn't get to voice our truth. We had situations that really, really didn't work or create alignment within that partnership. And so we really had to let those things go. The past really had some contemplation, some real thinking about what was okay in my life, what was not okay, and how can I change that? How can I move forward and create these new situations that are more meaningful? So we move on to the Judgment card. And so I feel that this is some karma. Scorpio, that person from the past that did all these things or maybe didn't allow you to open your throat chakra to allow you to really voice your truth. Well, judgment's coming. We got karma card here. This is also a card that can possibly be maybe you judged yourself about a particular situation. And for that reason, that judgment really was you judging yourself. It was you really poking and prodding and really not allowing yourself to really get the lesson, but just holding on to that depressive energy. And so we learned. We got through it, Scorpio. It was a hard time last year, but we managed to survive. And so that's why the Hierophant card shows up. It's like we really went within. We really tried to connect ourselves to a higher intelligence, something that created more space within our heart to maybe bring in more love. Maybe us not being so secretive about the things that we do. Maybe people not being suspicious when in all actual reality, we were doing nothing wrong. And so, Scorpio, we get to connect to the better parts of ourselves. The Hierophant asks that we let go of the past, that all of those notions that that individual maybe created in your life that caused heartache, well, we have to end that because we have the Devil card. And the Devil is really, to me, it's the same thing as the Death card. And so they both signify this ending of something and this new beginning, starting something fresh. Sometimes when we get the Devil card, we can say, let's go back in and create something different. Maybe voice our truth and hold our own when someone is really going against who we are as a person. Okay. And so that's why I say you do gain momentum in that. You do get these valuable lessons with the King of Wands. You do get to come back in and resurface that and say, hey, look, I'm just not going to take it anymore. That there are new things for me to experience. And I don't really want to hold myself in a negative space or even go into judgment against myself anymore. And so I think that this is a valuable lesson, Scorpio, for you to come in and learn. I'm going to pull two more cards here. We've got the Chariot card. So the Chariot card comes up and, you know, I say that that's the overall energy here is when the Chariot comes in, we have movement, we have transition, we get to move into the Queen of Cups energy and understand that we are valuable and that we won't be playing the second fiddle here anytime soon to anybody's endeavors but our own. And so I think that that's a really valuable lesson, Scorpio, is just to know that you're wonderful, know that there's great things about you. And if you don't feel like you're in alignment with something, don't try to push the issue. Just let it go. Maybe something beautiful is around the corner for you to experience, and maybe that will help you on your true life's path. So I hope this helped, Scorpio. If there's things in my reading that don't resonate with you, well, those weren't the juicy nuggets that you were supposed to keep. You're supposed to let those things go and keep the things that are valuable to you. And so I hope that this spelled a lot of truth for you, Scorpio, and know that I do see you as valuable. So moving forward, if you'd like a reading with me, there's some valuable information in the description box below. Please share, subscribe, and like my channel, The Intuitive Healer. And thank you so much. I love you guys. Have a beautiful day. Namaste.